Julia, thank you so much for joining me today. I have a summer project, and these are little sunglass cases. I have been selling these at different boutiques, in my Etsy shop, at flea markets, different craft shows for a while, and they are really good sellers. And so I thought I would make a series or just a themed set. This is nothing but blue skies. I thought how appropriate, because if it's blue skies, you're probably using your sunglasses. So I have three different designs in that within that same theme, and I do have a packet made and the templates made, all available on my Etsy shop, and I'll link that down below for you. I wanted to add, just talk a little bit about craft shows. And if any of you do craft shows, could you leave a comment in the description for me? I want to know if you have craft shows this year, because I have signed up for two shows, and they're bigger shows that I've done for years, both of them outside, and both of them have been canceled because of the COVID. One was at the end of August and one was at the end of September. And so I'm just curious if any of you else out there who do craft shows, if you have had the same experiences that I have had. But I thought I would share this project with you. Again, with any of my projects, feel free to make them and sell them the projects. I don't mind at all. In fact, I'm honored. I just think it's wonderful to be able to share and to live open-handed like that. I just ask that you don't sell the pattern. I did want to mention that there's a packet with the pattern that you do not need to print out. You can just it's just a helpful guide. There's some pictures and things that you might want to just be able to look at. So maybe you want it on your computer screen so you can take a look at it, but it's not necessary to print this out. But the other two pages you're going to want to print out, and that's the template and the pattern for the actual case itself, and then the design. And like all my designs, I've already flipped orientation, so you do not have to do that. You can trace right from the paper itself. So I hope you enjoy this. Let's get started. Supplies needed for this project is the template, and you're going to want to cut one out of the fusible foam. So this is a double-sided fusible foam. You're going to need some scraps for the applique, an inside and outside fabric. These are 8 inches by 9 inches. And then your template too with the applique designs. And you're going to need an iron-on adhesive. I'm using Heat and Bond Lite. The first step is to place your fusible foam that's been cut out of the template onto the wrong side of your outside fabric. I use that little cutout on the left-hand side. And then you're going to flip it over and gently iron this. I don't leave the iron on for very long because I don't want it to stick to my pressing surface, but just get it on there to get that in place. Now it's on to the appliques. I'm just going to grab my template and my Heat and Bond Lite and just trace right onto my Heat and Bond Lite. I have the paper side up. And you do not have to switch the orientation. I've already done that, so you trace it just as it is on your little applique design sheet. And I'm just using a mechanical pencil for this. I'm rough cutting my pieces out now, and I do not cut on the line at this point, but I am leaving an edge. Now it's on to ironing on your pieces on the back side of your fabrics. You're going to want to just read the directions on whatever iron-on fusible you have, and it'll tell you how long to leave your iron on. Just getting these into place. And again, I'm just rough cutting them out at this point. And once they're all ironed on, they will be fussy cut out, just going right on the line and cutting everything. I have different scissors for different things. This scissor is one that is sort of sharp because it has to cut through fabric, but it is somewhat dull because I am also cutting through the paper. And then I have scissors that is just for fabric, and then of course just paper scissors as well. I'm peeling off that paper backing on the sign so that I can see through it, and I'm just lining this up. I'm grabbing my pens that I used for tracing. These are all permanent pens. I have all three of them listed down below for you. I like them for different reasons. I have chosen to use my Pitt pens for this because it comes in four different sizes. The top writing is a little bit lighter or just a little bit finer. Now this is my handwriting, and so feel free to use your own handwriting, or if you have a certain font you like. Now I'm switching to my medium, decided to go with my boldface, I believe I use for this other part, just to have a bit of a variation. It's on to ironing on the applique to the front of my little case. I'm just getting the center. I want to make sure it's centered on the front. I'm trimming this extra little bit out. You still want to leave that half inch or so there, so you do have that seam allowance. But again, just folding, just trying to get it so that I can easily center this sun right on. I'm starting with the sun, peeling off that back paper, and then just getting my pieces lined up. And I just use the pattern to kind of see where things should be. And that's all included in the little packet. And once I have it the way I want it, I then again iron or fuse this into place. Opening this up again, and now it's to my sewing machine. I'm just going to be outlining everything using black thread, and I'm going to be free motioning this on. So I do have my feed dogs dropped, and I have my free motion foot on, and again I am just outlining all these pieces. I'm not too concerned if I get off a little bit. It gets wonky. I usually go over everything twice. I do like this sketched on look, but you can also use a satin stitch for this. Some machines have an applique stitch that you can also use. For the sign, I'd like to just do a little movement in each of the corners just to give it an appearance like it has a nail in each of the corners. And it's on to completing your case. You want to place your right sides together, so you're going to have your outer fabric and your inner fabric right sides together. You want to work so that your foam is up, and then place pins all the way around it. I do like to mark my opening, and I like that opening on the right hand side, approximately 4 inches, I'd say 4 or 5 inches. Now take it to your sewing machine and go all the way around right on the outside of this foam. And I do backstitch before, at the beginning and the ending. And you can see it there. It's just a scant eighth of an inch away from the foam. I'm clipping now, making sure to leave my opening. I don't clip my opening. And I'm just clipping away some of the fabrics in the corners. Just getting that bulk away, clipping my corners, and again leaving the fabric for on the opening. And then I also want to clip, very carefully clip my curve here, being careful not to clip any of my stitches. Now I'm just getting my fingers in there. And at this point, you might feel like the foam is lifting, and that is fine. Just get it all even, and it's going to be ironed back into place in the next step. Just putting my pokey tool in there and getting the corners. By leaving that scant eighth of an inch all the way around, your foam has room to lay flat. Rolling everything out. And now for that opening, I like to, the outer fabric just goes right over that foam, and you can iron that right into place, and it just sticks right to the foam. It's a really slick way. This double-sided foam is just great. And then I just use my iron to fuse that foam into place, giving it one crease. I do leave it open for this next step because I do want to top stitch all the way across the top. When I top stitch, I do use a longer stitch. On my machine, it's at a 3. And then I'm going to close up the side and the bottom. And I just take just a scant fourth of an inch to finish that. And I also want to make sure to back stitch several times on the top there, as that's a stress point. Your sunglasses, even large ones, fit in here so well. It's just such a cushy place to keep your sunglasses. I hope you enjoyed this video. Here's some pictures of all three of them. Bye for now.